Welcome Hardik also.
Welcome Hardik.
All three guests.
All of you got it all. Morning is really good. We have received it. Shall I begin the session, sir?
Yes.
Your permission.
Let's go ahead.
Okay. Very good morning to one and all connected by this virtual platform. On behalf of PRCM College of Business Administration, this is Dr. Divya Mehta. Welcome you all in today's session on life, career, and PRCM. There are three eminent alumni who share their successful life and inspiring career experiences, which includes PRCM also. And when it is also about BRCM family, I would request the head of our family, our principal, Sir Dr. Jayesh Desai, for a welcome note and also to orient us with the motive of the session. To you, sir.
Thank you, Divya. Good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure and privilege to welcome all, especially my alumni guests, Nisha, Piyush, and Hardik, and all students of SY, as well as a few admission aspirants in BRCM. It's a great opportunity for me to introduce the purpose of this program. Well, for last 3-4 months, we have been thinking about this, where one thought process was going behind our mind, that was we are organizing variety of guest lectures on different subject matters. Why we should not have something to motivate our students and help understand about how to shape their life and career. Original idea is to launch a series of lecture with the title Life, Career and Passion. We were thinking about how passion drives career and life. So that was something which we were thinking and discussing internally in our college amongst staff members. So, but in between this pandemic hit, and we could not organize anything, or we could not kickstart this lecture series. When we started online, we thought, in this life, career and passion, why not to invite some of our extremely passionate alumni who have done great in their life and contributed immensely to the economy and corporate world. So from that, we thought, why not to invite them and not just talk about their passion and their success story, but at the same time, ask them to talk something about BRCM and how it has been contributing, or it has contributed towards passion and career for their own development. So in this realm, we thought of this session. I'm extremely happy and thankful to all my three alumni. Nisha Talati, who happens to be our alumni from first batch, very first batch of BRCM College. Piyush Bhutoria, who did his BBA in 2006, and fortunately that's a sixth batch. Our numbering goes like this. So Piyush from sixth batch, and Hardik Shah from 11th batch. So even while choosing our alumni, we have kept reasonable spacing. Batch number 1, batch number 6, and batch number 11. Right. So in today's time, you can say different generations or different lot of BRCM. All of them have done great in their career. And during their time at college also, they have been extremely active. And somebody who felt for college at that point of time, and not only that, even after I would say 19 years, Nisha still feels so. After 15 years, I have experienced Piyush is almost with same enthusiasm to connect, and Hardik after 9 years, almost a decade. And even in that span, he has contributed a lot for his business and BRCM. Whenever we call, they are ready to connect. Right? I'm extremely thankful to all three speakers for agreeing to deliver this lecture. Not even a call, just on a WhatsApp message. So we are extremely thankful to all of you.
Thank you, sir.
I'll not take much time because we have given a very short time to our speakers. So I welcome you all, guests, all my SY students, and all students who have connected in this session, those who are interested in joining BRCM. So welcome you all. Thanks. Over to you, Divya.
With a welcome note, I can see the brightness on the faces of BRCM family members. So just a note, today's session is divided into two segments. The first segment, there will be insightful speeches of our speakers for the day. And after that, in the second segment, there will be question-answer sessions for the admission aspirants. Moving on, to begin our session, the first segment of our session, I would request Dr. Neha Sheth to introduce our first speaker, Ms. Nisha Anand. Neha madam, to you. You're mute, Neha madam. Microphone is to be on.
Yes. Thank you, Divya. A very good morning to one and all, and warm welcome to this virtual platform of BRCM College of Business Administration. Gems are polished and then it sparkles. And students like our guests are those gems who have sparkled with their own radiance. Ms. Nisha Anand, Mr. Piyush Gupta, and Mr. Hardik Shah. You all are charismatic pioneers of excellence in the aspect of quality. You have shown that excellence is another name for commitment and dedication. You have proved that discipline and hard work is path of success. I will say that radiance of sunshine is to bring joy, and your achievement drive the institute to believe that yes, we can, and yes, we have. So thanks for accepting our invitation, as Jayasa said, that on by WhatsApp message only. So I'm not taking much time. Let's start the conversation with introduction of our first speaker, Ms. Nisha Anand. So Nisha is student of our very first batch and achieved her degree of BBA in first year of this century, that is in 2001. She did her MBA from Tennessee University. Then she did his diploma in corporate communication and advertising from Paradise. She also took a degree from Harvard in performance measurement mentoring. She is interested in many other areas also. At present, she is a skilled coach and management consultant with experience in all managerial and behavioral aspects. She is a chief consultant of BCM Training Academy. She has received many awards like Outstanding Woman Entrepreneur by Southern Indian Chamber of Commerce, the another award for Inspirational Entrepreneur by IRMA, then Performance Excellence Alumni by BRCM College, and Young Creative Entrepreneur by British Council. She is very active. She delivers powerful workshops to students, entrepreneurs, and professionals. She is very active across the education ecosystem in Gujarat. She is also working on a social enterprising green project. The list is endless, so to define her all achievement will take much more time. So
I would now request Ms. Anand to enlighten us with her experiences and learnings. To you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So, first of all, a very, very big time thank you for this wonderful, amazing opportunity. I'm totally feeling so very honored, so very privileged that, you know, I'm sitting in front of all of you and sharing a platform with, you know, the faculties, you know, from whom we learned so much. And I welcome all the amazing, vibrant, dynamic students as well. You are right now sharing a platform with one of the finest colleges that I have known. The college that has actually, you know, shaped my thought process. The college that is actually, you know, like the way Neha mentioned, that, you know, the way gems actually sparkle is, you know, the entire process that actually goes into it. And that drilling has really happened, with which, you know, that really helped us become what we are today with the help of DRCM. All it's a big time thank you, and you know, this platform has given me an opportunity to kind of thank everybody once again, you know, to consider and share my gratitude for this amazing learnings that we have gained. So I don't want to take, you know, too much of my time, but I want to definitely share with you, not many, although, because, you know, if I start talking about the kind of learnings that I have gained that has made me what I am today. So today, while I had my own training and consulting organization, you know, if I go back the memory lane, like, you know, talking about, like, when I hear that, okay, it was like 19 odd years, it makes me feel really old now, because I'm the one of the oldest batch here. Nevertheless, you know, the learnings always, students remain fresh and, you know, they remain learners throughout their life. So I want to just, you know, not talk too much, but there are at least three things which I think I really want to mention, you know, in the time that I have been given. Although I can talk about, you know, for hours together about how DRCM has shaped my thought process. But yes, there would be at least three things that I want to share with you all today. So the first thing that I want to share is basically about, you know, what my major learning has been that actually framed my most important value is about life, which is like, you know, the college life, you know, like for all of us, when, you know, just like you, there was a time when we were like younger. I still consider myself young, so but yeah, we were still younger. So there was a time where, you know, we actually were out of the school life, and, you know, when we finished up our schooling and when we entered, you know, we were at the threshold of our adolescence, and we were enjoying that, you know, this thought process that now we are free, you know, we are free as we are out of college, and it is such a golden opportunity to enjoy the freedom, you know. But, you know, that is definitely true, that this is a process wherein, you know, we enjoy the freedom. But one learning that I gained during my association with BRCM, and that was that, you know, this is definitely a great opportunity to enjoy the freedom. But one most important element that I have gained and understood is that life in during the college time is basically, you know, preparing us for the future life. This is really not the life. Trust me, the life that you are right now in the college time, it's definitely a fantastic time, but trust me, this is just a preparatory stage. A preparatory stage to help you actually prepare for the real life that is to come, you know. So right now you might be worried that, you know, you have to study so much, and, you know, why not enjoy life, because youth is not going to come again. And there are so many things that we talk about as young, you know, students. But this is a time wherein we have to make the maximum, because this is the time when we would be preparing ourselves for future. So it is a kind of a training period that we are going to be there to, you know, face the challenges of tomorrow. While my association with BRCM as a student, the entire process of, you know, learning was not just because we were going to colleges and attending session, but there was real-time learning because there are teachers who actually actually understand you. There is, you know, an entire process, an entire system when you get a holistic learning. So, and this is very important, you know, if you do not get the right kind of a training in this preparatory stage, you know, you will not be able to face the challenges of tomorrow. So, yeah, so my point here that I wanted to share about is that, you know, treat this definitely as a golden opportunity. It is definitely freedom, but it is a preparatory stage. So you have to prepare yourself to the fullest and take this as a drilling, as a training period for the life to come, because there are so many more challenges for you to face, you know. Second learning that I have gained, the second very, very important learning that I have gained is basically that, you know, while we are talking about all of these challenges and we are talking about, you know, like say for now, right now also, resilience has become so important. The second important learning is that, you know, evaluation has become, you know, the factor for all kind of education systems. So if you're talking about, you know, if I'm going to a college or I'm going to school, so the reason why any student would really study would be ki I want to gain good marks and, you know, pass with right grades. But trust me, vomiting out just what you have read is really not going to help, right? So the process has to be thoroughly enjoyed. So I would not say, because my teachers are already here and they know that I was not always a very bright student, you know, a gold medalist and scoring the highest of the percentage in the college, but I have definitely enjoyed my learning process. So the kind of learning that I have gained, you know, whether we were preparing for our projects or whether we were preparing for our, you know, examinations, or whether we were just doing our general learning, that process of preparing is something that I have understood that in my initial years, you know, when we just joined college, for us it was like, let us enjoy to the fullest. And there were times when, you know, you don't feel like studying and you don't want to attend the lectures and you studying, you know, at the last moment because, okay, 2 days ke baad exam hai and, you know, we have to prepare. But then vomiting it out to, you know, just finish it up will really not help. So my college has really helped me realize the significance. That is, trying to understand that how enjoyable this process of learnings could be, not just examinations, but enjoying the learning, because these learnings are going to frame us and really create our future. And the third and the most important and the one that I value the most, and that is about my teachers, okay? So infrastructures, process, systems definitely count an important role. But teachers are like, you know, the soul of the education system. You know, they are like your conscience. Like, you know, some time back I read this amazing quote which said that, you know, people around you, especially your parents and your teachers, you know, their voices become the voice of your conscience. And trust me, this has been true. Like my teachers have really, helped me think about what I am, believe about who I am, and, you know, kind of create a bigger vision for myself. You know, because there are times when you try to be in yourself because you cannot see how good you could be. So you really need somebody who could trust in you, who could believe in you. So I would really want to say that, you know, you need a teacher who really believes, who can show you your strengths and who works with you to build your strengths even further. So, you know, in the process, I have even understood that there are times when, you know, young college students, even we have been a part of the system. So we all would, you know, want to make fun out of, you know, the education system and the educators. But there's something that I have learned in the process, and, you know, because this is a fantastic opportunity to connect directly to so many students at a time. And that opportunity I would not want to miss. I want to tell you this. And this is that, you know, respect your teachers. Because, you know, if we are able to respect a teacher who has actually dedicated their entire life in that subject, you know, upgrading themselves and gathering enough knowledge about that subject, and that teacher is there to, you know, share it with you wholeheartedly, who wants you to gain all the knowledge and all the experience that he or she has, you know, gained throughout the years and decades of, you know, his learning and practice, I think that's a fantastic opportunity. So I I believe that, you know, the teachers who actually create, you know, a belief in you would actually create a future for you. So these were the basic three things that, you know, I really wanted to mention that, you know, for me, BRC in college has helped me, number one, believe in, you know, myself, because right from the day one of my college, I could see there was enthusiasm within me, and I could see the same amount of enthusiasm in the, you know, fraternity, the entire college fraternity. And when you are studying, and you know, you have so many high aspirations and you want to achieve so many things and you also want to have a lot of fun. So with that, knowing what is the right track, you know, which is the right decision, where to go, where not to go, because there's so much of peer pressure around that you do not really know what's the right and the wrong. So at that time, if you know, if you are in the right hands, if you are in the right process, and if you are in the right system, you will definitely be assured that your future is going to be safe. So with, you know, that kind of a mindset, I have been, you know, so blessed to be a part of this entire college fraternity. And I feel that, you know, how much ever I would give back to the college, it would be less. So I have continued to, you know, share my thoughts with my college faculties and the management that whenever you feel that, you know, I could be of any or contribution to the college, you know, words and time has no limitations, and I will always be, you know, and glad, more than happy to, you know, share this platform. So once again, you know, I want to thank you for giving me this opportunity, you know, to share with you about what my, you know, learnings have been. And began my career after, you know, my graduation, what I have understood is that life is continuously a learning process, and the kind of challenges that are thrown to you, there will be times that, you know, we fail so many times. So failure, I do not mean by, you know, getting failures. Trust me, these are going to be like very, very little things in your life. But the learnings that you gain out of it, the learnings are really going to, you know, build resilience in you. So we really need to understand this as a process that, all right, so when I'm talking about like my experience and my challenges, all of these have added so much to building up to, you know, the kind of a person that I have now become. And I still see that, you know, my benchmarks are much higher, and I have to still work so hard to reach all my goals. So I, you know, wish you all the same, that you all dream big. Don't worry about the failures and give you 100%. Trust me, what really matters is you, your willpower, your decision making, as in what do you really want to do out of the kind of gift of life that you have been given. So there are so many amazing people around you who are willing to help you. So take this as an opportunity, and, you know, instead of evaluating and judging, see what best you can make out of the given opportunity. And trust me, you will reach places. You know, just give 100% to, you know, whatever you are doing, and you'll be able to do places. So with that, I do not want to take much time, because I see that two more speakers who might want to listen to as well. So thanks so much again for. And it's a pleasure, you know, connecting. And I once again wish all the students of one of these institutes who have actually given the best environment, talking about the kind of upbringing, the kind of process, the belief system within you is actually person. So once again, thank you so much, BRTN College, for this opportunity and for helping me become what I am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for enjoying the freedom by valuing the time, decision making, and self-evaluation and whatnot. It's really motivating for all of us. I would now request Dr. Neha Sheth to introduce us with our second speaker, Mr. Piyush Kutoria. Neha Madam, to you.
Welcome, Piyush.
Luis Gutierrez is also BRCM alumni by this time, you all know, who achieved his degree of BBA in marketing in 2006. So exactly after 5 years of Nisha. Then he did his PGDM in international business from KJ Sumaya Institute of Management Studies and Research. He has diverse experience of values in the domain of sourcing, sales, category and business management with a proven track record in vendor management, product marketing, business development, key account management, channel source management, project sales, manpower management and branch management. Which area you have left, I don't know. We believe in excellence, integrity, meritocracy, progress through mutual learning and development. His excellence in strategic thinking, customer relationship management, negotiation, business communication, client and talent acquisition, resource optimization, and whatnot. He has started managing portfolio of 18 crore with Godrej and Boy Manufacturing Company Limited, Hyderabad. And then worked with many reputed industries like Pidilite, OCI Lombard, etc. And today he is associated with OCSIL Limited, China, as International Sourcing and Product Development Manager. And there he is managing portfolio of value $21 million per annum. If I talk about his responsibility and key achievements of all these different projects, and we have very little time, so we are eager to listen to him. So welcome Piyush on this BRCM again platform again, and that is your job.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, everyone. So a very warm good morning to all my faculty members. I would rather call you as a family member because BRCM cannot be removed from my life. So I'll just give you a brief on how I got associated with BRCM. I'm born and brought up in Kolkata, and after completing my school education, I shifted to Surat, and I was scouting for good institutes where I could apply for graduation. And after basic primary research, BRCM was the absolute choice for me, no doubt about that. And look, in Desi language mein kahu to the feedback I got from my acquaintances was, agar tumko padhai karna hai to BRCM mein chale jao. That was the feedback which I had, and then I explored further and I realized that, yeah, this would be the right choice. And I was fortunate enough to have an admission with the institute. So I'm really grateful for the history that I've had with BRCM, and I hope that I can continue the relationship in an active way in the future as well. And many thanks to all the faculty members at that point of time, Manoj sir, Jayesh sir, Neha ma'am, Bipul sir, Runal sir, and few others. It's a very overwhelming exercise for me today that guru ke samne main shishyon ko gyan dene ki koshish kar raha hu. So pardon me for any mistakes that I commit here. And all I am trying to do is experience sharing, nothing else. Zyada kuch gyan dene ki koshish nahi karunga. So I'll take the help of few slides which I have prepared for my fellow friends. I'm not sure whether the screen would be visible. Please give me your feedback. Is the screen visible, ma'am?
No. Screen is not visible. You are visible, but your screen is not visible.
Okay. So in order to save time, we'll not wait for the screen sharing. I'll just share my thoughts across. So the agenda which I've kept is some opening thoughts, thoughts on essentials for a successful career, then institute's role in our career and life, business environment today and the careers, importance of decision making, and few learnings from my experiences. So when Jayesh sir approached me about the talk today for life, career, and BRCM, I thought why not present some thought about these three terminologies. So for me, life is a journey one creates for self with or without impact of the external factors around and with or without impacting others' lives. So basically what I mean is that there would be certain people and certain situations which will impact you and vice versa. But in the midst of all these things, whatever you create for yourself as a journey is life. Now coming to career, I think if you Google it out or maybe you read some good books, you will find phenomenal definitions. But this is how I see career as. A career is a constellation. There are many stars in one's life, even in occupational life. Also, you could call it as a professional life. And if you see, create or form a pattern, you could name it as a career. So what I mean is that you, one person can do many things in life, and the space or the field where you dedicate yourself, where you have a certain amount of contributions and achievements, that phase of life is called a career. The beauty of the fact is that one can choose the design or shape he wants to create or she wants to create. And now coming to BRCM. Again, BRCM needs no introduction on this platform. It is one of the best institutes which is placed in Surat. And for management education, I think this is one of the best institutes one can look forward to. And I would say not just for the formal education, also for mentoring, guidance, career shaping. This is one of the best platforms we could have in Surat. But I would still like to say that, friends, an institute at its best is a facilitating entity. It can help you to gain knowledge. It can help you to create a vision for future. But at the same time, you are the person who takes the onus of your own career and your own life. I mean, we can take a lot from our institute, but ultimately the responsibility lies on us how we shape our career and future. So essentials for a successful career. I think the following points are very important to define career as well as shape it in a very successful manner. The first and foremost is that you should have a vision and mission emanating from passion. Hello?
Yes, you are audible.
I just want to have a check whether I'm audible or not. Yeah, because there was no noise, so I thought that if I'm disconnected. Yeah, sorry for the interruption. So every student in his or her own life should try to develop a vision for themselves. What do they want to do in life? What makes them happy? What is their passion? Because if you choose a career which is not driven by passion, trust me, initial few years, you can taste success in terms of money, fame, achievements. But in the long run, if you lack passion, careers will not be built. It will just be a spending of time which you will be doing in your job or your profession or your business. But choose your career, whether it is a job or a business, built from your passion. Second important thing is that dedication with relentless focus and efforts is required. Now, with vision and mission, you can identify the path or direction that you want to move on. But dedication is very important because in life, at every stage, you will be thrown up with immense number of challenges and wherein you will always find yourself running after resources and constraints and then achieving your objectives. So dedication is very important for you to keep going. The third point which I would like to focus is Kaizen. It's a concept from Japanese manufacturing technologies, wherein it is a mandate to continuously upgrade your manufacturing processes on a day-to-day basis. So is the case with our minds and our skills. we should continuously focus on upgrading our knowledge and skills. I'm pretty sure that the faculty of our institute also have upgraded a lot with time. 15 years ago, what was being taught has now witnessed a sea change. And that is the way even the students and the professionals in life have to proceed. Because without constant upgradation, you are not catching up with the ongoing trends in the world, as well as the changes that are happening for good. And irrespective of what you do, the next thing which is important for everybody is people skills. Someone can say that I am introvert, or he is naturally extrovert, she is very good at connecting with people, I am not. Irrespective of the fluency or the nature of the person, everybody has to develop people skills. Because ultimately we live in a social world wherein, of course, today we are at a social distancing protocol, but at the same time, you will need to work with people, you will need to spend time with people, and hence the skills to manage people, to interact with people, and to propel decisions with people is very important. So people skills is the area where everybody should focus on and try to work on a day-to-day basis. And last but not the least, you should have a positive attitude. Again, life may or may not be fair with everybody. Everyone may or may not have the same amount of resources or opportunities, but positive attitude can help you sail through all the challenges and achieve the best possible that you are due to achieve. So these are the essentials of successful career, which I believe from my experience. And now we come to the institute's role in career and life. Again, I cannot quantify or summarize what BRCM as an institute or any institute in general can play in one's life. But there are certain things which we can phrase as the most important roles played by them in our career and life. Why I say career and life? Because from an institute, we don't just get the ammunition to build careers. Actually, if you see, you build a career or not, but your institute provides you with
Sir, you're getting disconnected. Your mic is off. It's showing me.
Hello?
Yes. It's audible now.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Sure. Thanks. So I was saying that the institute's role is very much beyond your career only. So what does an institute do for a student? Of course, it provides an industry-driven structured course and provides a certificate once you clearly successfully pass out all the examinations. But beyond that, which is more critical, is the mentoring. One or many of the faculties at the institute can become your mentors. And mentors are very essential for anybody to identify their own potentials and unlock those potentials to maximize their gain, to maybe achieve some objectives. If there is no mentor, then I believe that a person's life or journey is directionless. When I talk about institute's role from my own experience, BRCM has been very much instrumental in providing a quality exposure to the industry as well, apart from the academics, which was in the form of projects, internships, and also various co-curricular activities. This is one field where I feel that Neha ma'am had pushed me throughout the 3 years that I was there. And I never regret following her advice, and I think I've had a lot of learning experiences through that. And apart from quality exposure to these industry platforms, the networking that we do within our batch, within our institute, seniors and juniors, like today through this forum, I'm able to know about Hardik and Nisha. So maybe we will network in future, maybe or may not be, but there is an opportunity to network with people. there are lots of people who are doing many different things, and you never know who could be helpful for you in a very small task of your life or maybe in a big project that you are planning to take up. So it is very important to stay networked, because that makes you more and more resourceful. And last but not the least, as Nisha had highlighted, that lectures bunk karne ka bhi man karta hai kabhi kabhi, but that will not happen if you don't have friendships. So this institute or any other institute would definitely give you an immense opportunities to identify friends, enjoy life. So don't miss out on those opportunities. In the pursuit of building a career or a professional life, don't miss out on your present. Jahan bhi mauka milta hai, do enjoy life. Because at the end of 10 years or 20 years, you will see ki haan, mere paas ek degree hai. But at the same time, if you have phenomenal fond memories, then life is more meaningful, I think. And we do agree that friendship can happen with your faculty members also. I see that when I talk to Neha ma'am or Jay sir or any other person from the institute, main ek friend se hi baat kar raha hu, just that there is a level of seniority and experience, to ek respect bhi aata hai, that cannot get eliminated. But I feel that I'm talking to a friend. So I think these are very important things in your life, and you should always try to gather them, try to cherish them. Kyunki ye aapko personally and professionally dono tarike se help karte hain. So do enjoy your life. Don't just be a bookworm, and try to add value to yourself and people around you. This is what BRCM has taught me. Now, the next I would briefly touch upon is business environment and career. I have a complaint here ki our lecturers, our faculties had always papaw-fied us for 1 hour, 50 minutes, but they have given us less than 20 minutes time today. I have so much to talk to, and I feel ki I am not able to do justice to the topics. But anyways, I will summarize this topic in just 2 minutes. The business environment, as we all know, is ever-changing. It has been ever-changing in the past also, but now the speed has increased. So if you are interested, you can also read the book by Bill Gates, which is Business at the Speed of Thought. It will be immensely inspiring for you guys. So my point here is that the business dynamics are changing on a day-to-day basis. 4 months ago, business was being done in a different way. Today, you see, due to COVID, businesses have transformed. Hotels have become hospitals. Who would have thought? The biggest of the biggest business leaders did not have this vision. Someday I will use my hotel as a hospital temporarily. But what has to happen, happens. So my point here is that never, never operate in silos. Never, never operate with a stereotype mindset. Ki dunia mein aisa hi chalta hai, aisa hi chalega. If you believe that, then you are doomed today or tomorrow. So always be open and always try to adjust according to the changing landscapes. Now we are also living in an interesting world of collaborative competitiveness. Competition is cutthroat, but at the same time you see competitors are also collaborating with each other. Facebook and Google are competitors, but Google ke Android software mein Facebook ka app by default hota hai. So this is just one example wherein I mean to say is you create your business fundamentals, you create your fundamentals of operations very sound and very strategic, and then the sky is the limit. Aapke competitor bhi aapke sath collaborate karne ko majboor ho jaye, itna acha kaam karoga. So that is the idea. With these things, opportunities are ample in the world. Highly specialized roles are also getting developed. Aaj ki date mein artificial intelligence has become the talk of the town in the technology space. Today countries are fighting for a leadership position in artificial intelligence. They know ki aaj jisne leadership position le liya hai, wo agle 15-20 saal tak economically superpower reh sakta hai. So this is the direction where the world is moving. So we need to identify ki hame kis field mein kaam karna hai, kis field mein hum acha kaam kar sakte hain, kis field mein rehke hum khush reh sakte hain. So these kinds of thought processes will help you identify कि आपको किस डायरेक्शन में स्पेशलाइज करना है. बिकॉज समवेयर और द अदर यू हैव टू मेक चॉइसेस वेयर एंड हाउ डू यू वांट टू प्रोसीड इन लाइफ, बी इट योर बिजनेस, बी इट अ जॉब, बी इट एनजीओ काइंड ऑफ सोशल वर्क. but you have to take decisions on these lines. The next thing is, no matter how much high technology levels industries have gone through or education has taken an upgradation, but still business leaders find that there is a gap in the workforce quality and the expectations of the organizations. Last year, I was reading that Tech Mahindra's CEO was mentioning that 90% of the freshers that they hire from campus, they are not fit for the basic level jobs. Now, does that mean that they have taken a wrong decision? No. They are left with no choice. They have taken the best of the best possible, but still they are unfit for the basic level jobs. Why so? Because of the difference in attitude and to some extent difference in exposure. So what they mean to say is that there is a more need for collaboration between institutes, educational institutes and the industry. So I'm sure that BRCM is also working on those lines on a continuous basis. But as a student, I would encourage that try to engage more and more on practical side of management education, which would be through taking up projects or working on certain assignments from your, which you can seek from your faculties. Or if you have association or opportunity to connect with some industry leaders, try to do that. Try to work on projects on a live basis and take help from your faculty and friends to make it a learning experience. And I'm sure you'll be prepared for industry as well as your own business plans or career plans that you wish to take up after graduating from your institute. Now, I'll just briefly touch upon one point that no matter what field you choose, no matter what specialization you take, suppose I take up marketing as a specialization. Please don't make a notion that marketing choose kiya to mere ko finance ke subjects ka knowledge nahi bhi hoga to chalega. Because this is a very big blunder which anybody can tend to make. When you choose marketing as a specialization, you are choosing a focused field for your own working. But in any department you are into, you need to have a holistic knowledge of business. Aaj ki date mein yahi bada problem aata hai companies mein. सर्विस वाला सेल्स वाले के पेन को नहीं समझता है, सेल्स वाला मैन्युफैक्चरिंग वाले के पेन को नहीं समझता है, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग वाला लीगल डिपार्टमेंट की पेन को नहीं समझ रहा है. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग ऑन अ डे टू डे बेसिस. ये जमानों से चला आ रहा है और शायद आगे भी थोड़ा चलता रहेगा. बट द आइडिया हियर इज अ ट्रू लीडर और अ गुड लीडर हैज अ होलिस्टिक व्यू ऑफ द बिजनेस. वो सभी डिपार्टमेंट्स के पेन को समझता है, प्रोसेस को समझता है, नीड्स को समझता है, एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे आर एबल टू connect with all of them and take them together as a unit. आज अगर एक गाड़ी का एक पहिया और दूसरा पहिया coordinated operate नहीं करेंगे तो गाड़ी आपको अच्छा performance नहीं दे सकती है. So you have to become that connecting force. You have to have a holistic view and you need to think 360 degree. Don't specialize in your skills and operations is fine, but don't specialize in your thought process. You need to have a total quality management mindset. And with this, I think I would like to rest my thought process here. And maybe some other time, if we have opportunity, we will connect again. And I would be able to share some more knowledge from you as well as to you. And once again, I thank the faculty, the team members from BRCM for providing an opportunity to talk to the forum. And I hope that I'll add value to the team that is connected online today. Thanks a lot.
Sure, sir. Definitely we'll plan one more time having with you for more specific talk. You have talked of people skill and holistic learning and practical learning. More importantly, I mean, you as a person are responsible. That is what I could just summarize. I would now request Dr. Neha Sheikh to introduce us with our third speaker, Mr. Hardik Shah. Neha madam, to you.
Piyush and Nisha, I agree with all your thought points and everything. I still remember when I recollect the name of Nisha, immediately in my mind it comes the name of Lina also and Parul also. Right, and when I remember the Piyush, immediately Ashish come in my mind. When I recollect the name of Hardik, Dolly and Anjali and Kshama and Naveen and everyone come in mind. They all people still, they all are also doing very well in life, and they all are still connected with us. So we are very happy, as Piyush said, Misha said, that we all are, with the same wavelength, with the same heart, they are talking with us at present also. They are sharing there. And today we have, that's why Piyush, aapko thodi si jo problem hai ki humne aap logo ko ek ghante pakaya har roz, to aapko bhi ye chance milna chahiye. Yes, with all positive that you are really, you all have given us this up. Yes, in just one say, so we are also very happy, and definitely we are planning for that also, that we can give you more time so our students can understand very well that, and that is also in our pipeline, and as you all are extending your hands for that, we are really happy about that, because I think the Hardik will also say the same thing. He is the youngest. I am not saying Nisha, you are the oldest, because otherwise then we people are definitely old. So now we don't have much time, but yes, all your say love for the college and everything, we are accepting with full heart, and definitely we again try our level best that we can call you again and take your all experiences and share with the students. So now time for Hardik. So Hardik is very young business leader, and he achieved his BBA degree in finance from BRCM College in year 2011, exactly after 5 years of Piyush. So it's a regular break of five years we have taken. Then he did his master in business management from SP Jain Institute of Management and Research, Mumbai. He is also a qualified chartered accountant. See, from all these three speakers, you can understand now the people are not much focusing in education in the sense that how it will be helpful or something. But from this three eminent speaker, you can understand that, yes, study is more core point in your this 5 years. Yes, rest of the things, whatever you want to do, you can do freely. The Hardik, he has joined his family business in his very young age with his education only. He has an experience of decade working of in his family business of jewelry named BR Design, one of the leading luxury jewelry brands of India, and has been featured in Economic Times Now for Leaders of Tomorrow. Now, owing to this marketing experience, he has won 360 degree marketing campaign of the year award in the jewelry industry. So in very, his career path is of hardly 5 to 7 years. And then also he has achieved a lot in his life. And he has also done executive course from the Cambridge University and from London School of Business Economics. So welcome Hardik, dais is now yours.
Good morning. Good morning to all my teachers and the entire BRCM family. Ma'am, thank you for the generous introduction. I would like to thank the BRCM College of Business Administration for initiating this session. It's a trip down memory lane. I mean, when I was listening to the experience shared by Nisha ji and Piyush ji, I had flashback of my college days, and it was very heartwarming. I couldn't agree more with what they said. I mean, they were point on, and being the junior out of all the three, I mean, what they said made complete sense. In the interest of time, I'm going to just cut short a little and come to the gist of the entire conversation. So I joined the BRCM in 2008, as ma'am had said. I had come from a science background. Now, the reason that I'm sharing you my story is that is to show that even if you're from a science background, you could do a commerce course, right? So my reason was I wanted to pursue management education, considering that I thought a BBA course will expand my understanding of businesses. you have the possibility of working with nearly any industry that matches your interest based on the function of your choice. Regardless of the industry, you could be doing human resources, you could be doing marketing, you could bring in sales, you could oversee operations, you could supervise finances and BBA for me at that point of time was a super hero of all the courses, which allowed me to have all these exposures and experiences. And BRCM was the obvious choice because it is still the best college in entire South Gujarat. And I remember one of my seniors told me, Hardik, it is the only college in South Gujarat where all the teachers are doctorate holders. You'll never find such eminent faculties to learn from, apart from any other institute. So I think I'm very lucky and fortunate that I took his advice to the heart and went for it. I must say that I'm very proud of the decision that I made. So, how college life? I mean, college life, BRCM College is going to impart the best education to all the possible students. But I'm not going to speak about education. I'm going to speak about things which are not mentioned in the admission prospectus. Things which probably help us more in life and prepare us for life ahead and how to take things forward. I'm going to talk about five skills that was cultivated in BRCM. That is what I'm going to speak about. Education, BRCM is the best. I mean, there is no qualms about it. And I mean, ma'am and sir and Jay sir and everyone would be the best person to tell you about the curriculum. But I'm going to speak something outside the curriculum, which I learned in college, which I think BRCM was the only college at that point of time that provided me the opportunity to do so. It helped me, develop my personality, brush up my intellectual skills, improve my communication level, and make me more ethical. So all these five points were fulfilled, and it exceeded my expectations. Also, I was very fortunate to have very supportive seniors who also pushed me to excel. And I recommend all FY and FY students, if you are listening, please help your, please look up to your TY students for help and guidance. I mean, they could provide you with very valuable insights, and those are the best friendships that I cultivated, not just in my year, but across all 3 years. And I would request TY students to help their fellow FY and FY students. The five skills that I wanted to touch upon, the first of it is communication. Communication, what I experienced and learned in BRCM was, it was not just very theoretical, but it was very practical in the sense. Practical in the sense that we had been given opportunities to do group discussions, we had been given opportunities to debate, we had word-guessing games. Also, it really helped our thought process, wherein we were pushed to take part in public speaking and other competitions that were regularly organized. So all this really helped me to prepare. A very prime example is, for example, I was Nehamem approached me to give this speech. So I was told, okay, you have to do this. So I think of all those skills that I learned there has helped me today to do all of this. And even when we go for any business meetings or we have any conference of public speaking and communication is the most important thing. And theoretical education there as well as the practical training imparted there really helped me. The second skill that I was, very much helpful that I cultivated in BRCM was the problem-solving skill. Now, problem-solving skill is something which, is really helpful to us to proceed further in our life. Just to give you an example. For example, if we are given a task to coordinate or participate in an event, it gives us the confidence and strength to face people in our work. Because when we work with people, there are multiple problems. And the best way is to find those solutions, implement it. So in college life, we were given those opportunities wherein we hold our problem-solving skills. Also, one example that I previously remember that we had a business plan competition. We had, what was it called? Reverse case study problems, wherein we were made to think from the problem statement as well as the solution statement and going reverse. I mean, I think that has really helped us developing our problem solving skills, which in today's time really help us to analyze the situation both from the front and the back side of it. You know? And that is something which at that point of time did not seem very important and evident. But if I look at hindsight today, I think it was the most important thing that I learned in the college. I always used to think, yeah, ye problem to hume banaya banaya milega, hume to solution hi dena hai. But when we came into the real life, we understood ki problem bhi aapko hi banana hai aur solution bhi aapko hi uska dena hai. So that really helped me there. So that's all on problem solving. I think the third important skill which I personally developed was pressure handling. I remember the assignment deadlines and the tests and the 6 month semester along with pursuing my chartered accountancy, which also is a very time consuming and course. So there was so much pressure to compete, pressure to fulfill both the courses, and pressure to excel in class. So मैं तो ये बोलूँगा, I think my 3 years of college was like a pressure cooker for me, and at the end of all those 3 years, I came out with a very good product. It really helped me to prioritize things. It really helped me to do excellent in terms of time management. And pressure handling taught me the most valuable skill is that is to be punctual, because at the end the result mattered, and the result mattered at the correct point of time. So the result and both the timing is something which was inculcated in me by all the assignments. We were supposed to do all the questionnaires, do survey, do the statistics on those surveys and everything. So that really again helped me. So at that point of time as a student, and I'm very sure as you guys are also there, you must be thinking, yaar, ye kya ho raha hai yaar, kya use aayega life mein? You must be having all those questions. But if you see that, so you are being trained to handle pressure, meet deadlines, and be punctual. And that is a key takeaway out of it, apart from the education that you're getting from the exercise. The fourth most important thing that I learned from BRCM was the ability to learn and unlearn. Probably this has helped me 4 to 5 years after I left the college. You know, once I did my college, I'm a chartered accountant, I did my MBA, I thought I know everything. MBA, mane baddu avade. That was the mindset that we had. But in practical life, it was very, very different and very, very difficult. You need to understand what is in the book and what is practically is two different, how would I say, universes. That is how would I would want to describe it. And the ability to learn at that point of time, that this is right and this is not right. And maybe what I learned was not right. Or if it was right, it was in some other context. In this context, it was not right. So the ability to learn and unlearn has really helped me in life. And because of this skill, today, be it any subject or be it any area of work, I am very much able to adapt myself and, you know, handle the situation. The last and the most important point that I would like to say, which is very important in the current scenario, are three words: improvise, adapt, and overcome. The situation, I remember someone from the faculty members had told me that change is the only constant in the world. I'm not recollecting who told that, but that has always stayed in my mind, in the sense that duniya mein sirf change hi aisi cheez hai wo constant hai, baaki sab badlega, matlab badlav hi jeevan hai. And agar aap wo sthiti ko samajh nahi sakte, usko parakh nahi sakte और उसका सोल्यूशन नहीं ला सकते, तो आपने जीवन में क्या सीखा? तो इम्प्रोवाइज, अडैप्ट एंड ओवरकम इज समथिंग विच आई लर्न्ड इन कॉलेज. आई रिमेम्बर अ पर्टिकुलर एक्सपीरियंस. हम कोई जगह पे कॉलेज को कोई स्किट रिप्रेजेंट करने जा रहे थे, एंड वन ऑफ अवर टीम मेंबर्स फेल इल, राइट, एंड ही वाज प्लेइंग अ क्रिटिकल पार्ट. अभी कॉलेज की इज्जत का सवाल है, हम पर्सनली हमारी इज्जत का भी सवाल है. सो एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम वी लर्न, ओके, हमें ये करना है, हमें ऐसे करना है, ये करना है. सो दैट क्विक डिसीजन थिंकिंग, adapting to the circumstances, they're overcoming, and we won that competition on for the record. So again, that is something which was inculcated for us in the college by facing. This is just one example I give. I might have a list of at least 100 other examples where we must have implemented this. In other words, you can also call it jugaad, but it should work. That is the whole point. So these were the five takeaways that I learned from the college. And you know, that has formed an important base of my life. Probably, had I not done BBA, I would have not become a chartered accountant. If I had not become a chartered accountant, I would have not done the other executive courses. I mean, everything is connected. Probably, agar aap logo ko lagta hai yaar, things are not making sense at this point of time. They might not make sense at this point of time, but in the hindsight, probably 2 to 3 years, 4 years down the line, and when you look back, probably it will all fit in together and it will make sense to you. And that has happened with me, and that's the reason I'm sharing this with you. In the end, I would say for every student out there who are thinking about their career options, I mean, BBA ke baad, mere paas list hai 15 se upar career options hai. There is no dearth of any field that you cannot take. I would like you to be well prepared. If you want to do something, just go for it. Yeah. I mean, I know some people say they have plan A and they have plan B, but what I would say is you have only one way and one goal. Just put all your efforts and hard work into it, and if it pays off, it will be the best decision of your life. So again, that mindset and that thought process has been cultivated in the college, because our school is, when you come out of school, you're very raw. It is college where you get multiple exposures, where you get more freedom, and how do you manage that freedom is something, which is an important lesson in your life. Lastly, I would say that I was just a carbon when I joined BRCM. BRCM organized me and made me in a diamond, and I'm sure it will be the same for you guys as well in the coming future. Thank you.
Thank you, Hardik. You rightly said that the theoretical knowledge we get from the book and the practical world waiting outside the institution and yourself and the support that you get being in the institution help you fill in the blanks. Okay. Now, before we get towards the end of first segment of the session, I would ask all the speakers, do you have some more time with you to be continuing with us? If you have some time, the second segment that we have of question answers, there might be some students of SY who might be interested in asking you something, full of bubbling with the queries they might be having in their minds. So would you be able to continue with us for some more time?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
All three years, I think.
There's always time.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much for this unconditional support. I guess, Jay sir, should we go to first formal vote of thanks and then to the question answer segment or continue with
the
segment?
We can continue with the question answer.
Okay then. If there are some queries of students, second year students to begin with, then the admission aspirants, the people who have got by now some idea of BRCM, can raise the queries if you have some. My second year students, if you have some query, unmute yourself or write in the chat box and can ask. Regarding life, career, BRCM, I'm sure you are almost answered. For second year students, I'm talking about.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Can I ask something, ma'am?
To whom you want to ask? You need to first say that and then your question.
Ma'am, my question is general. I would like to get information about a bid manager and its role in organization and how we will become and get the degree of the bid manager.
The professionals here can answer, I guess, or that they require some more.
By asking bid manager, do you have some special profession in mind? Means bids are submitted in stock market also, for auctions also. So any idea, or you just say bid manager?
Sir, in specially organization, I just got information about it.
May I address this question? I will try to.
Please, sir.
Hi, Tilak. From your phrase of bid manager, I can understand that you are trying to find job opportunities with the organizations wherein you would play the role of a procurement manager. Yeah. And you would be responsible for applying for various tenders or private entities' purchase requirements. Is that right?
Yes, sir. Exactly. This is.
Yeah. So, what do you have in mind? I mean, do you want to build a career around this option? If that is the case, I would say that, again, coming back to my summarized talk today, firstly, you need to focus on your career plan and your vision, right? If you are clear that I want to get into the procurement business or procurement roles with certain organizations, still, I would say that continue with your education with an open slate, open frame of mind. With focus on the bid management roles, you can try and work on certain projects while undergoing your education. However, I would say that for some organizations, procurement is a very strategic role. So they may not entertain trainees in this particular role. Please understand. But at the same time, you can identify organizations wherein you can get to have hands-on experience on non-critical startup level jobs or assignments, and then with the learning you can further pursue with some occupations with these organizations. But the first thing is get admission into your graduation. I'm assuming that you are a fresher, correct me if I'm wrong. Even if you are in the second year now, you could plan your summer internship and maybe other concurrent assignments with such roles in mind. And for bid management, I would say that your critical skills would be analytical skills, right? Your skills required would be negotiation skills. It would be required, you would be required to have good market intelligence. When I say market intelligence, it does not mean sales side. Market intelligence would also mean ki what are the industry norms, who are the key players, what are the ongoing trends, and you have to assess what is your position with no clear-cut information available to you. So, these things you have to keep in mind, and don't worry about all the jargons which I have thrown upon in you. When you work in this field, you will get the hang of all the things. So, it comes with time. Am I able to address your concern?
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir, for giving me information.
One of the students in the chat box has written, did you all try to earn money while you were studying?
They were all active at least. Anusha was active. Aditya was active.
Let them answer, madam.
Well, I would just like to share my little experience here. So it's a very interesting question, and you know, this kind of question to me. So you know, all youngsters pass through this. That is, you know, we feel that now we've become matured, and you know, we can. So just to share about my experience here. So you know, in during the college time, I believe there was this organization that I was associated with. I was associated with an NGO. So it was called as Young Giants International. That time I joined these organizations, you know, because I had this contribution kind of a feeling. I really want to give back to the society. So that time we founded this organization. So what we did was, you know, there was a Kargil war that time, and we created a very huge fundraising event. And those days were the times of, you know, boogie woogie dance competition. I don't know, some of you must have heard about it. So this is just one instance that I'm talking about, wherein we created a huge platform for a dance competition. We invited all the young, you know, people, we a lot of age groups, and then we collected a lot of registration. And I'm so happy to share with you that we created a fund of around 1 lakh rupees through this entire campaign. We created a check and we actually gifted it for the Kargil war. So this not only helped us, you know, organize so many things, you know, right from the idea as to how to generate the money, plus contributing back to the society, that was our purpose, and then coordinating so many things and so many things that we learned in the process, you know, working with the team, and the like hundreds of applications. So yes, we did try, like this was just one of it, but we did try earning, you know, money. But that time, you know, the focus was not to increase our pocket money. So
yes, the purpose matters.
Yeah,
yes.
The purpose was actually to give back to the society, so that, you know, somebody could make use out of it. So that was my story, although.
Thank you, ma'am. Is there any other question from second year student or from the other aspirants? For Hardik, I guess there's some question in chat box.
I think the question is for Satyam Mishra.
Yeah.
So Satyam, so basically you want to make your career in stock market as a technical analyst, and you say that BBA in finance really will help you for this. So yes, I think BBA in general will help you to become a stock market analyst. It will be a supporting degree. In the sense that BBA finance, I think when we were in the college, at that point of time, stock market was one of the subjects that we had, and we learned as to how to trade, when to set the floor and ceiling and the butterfly and everything. Again, being a technical analyst, you would require some other specialized 6 months or a 1 year course, but definitely BBA finance will help you to do that. Being in science team or commerce team, I don't think so that really matters if you want to be a stock analyst.
Yes, I guess the question is answered. Is there any other question for the speakers?
Yes, there is a question about CAT preparation.
CAT preparation, specialization.
I think Piyush can take up that.
Okay. Hello.
Yes, yes.
Am I audible? Yeah.
Yeah.
So, see, I would say that there is no one defined way of approaching CAT exams. But one thing is very clear, that you have to brush up your fundamentals, which is basic education up till 10th. And you need to focus on your language, mathematics, logical reasoning. These are the three things that you have to work upon. And as I had, I reiterate my point that speed is very critical. And speed ke saath accuracy aayegi, toh aap successful ho CAT mein. This is in a nutshell. If you ask for my experience, I had explored 3 to 4 options which were available at that point of time in Surat. And based on my understanding of a good decision, I had opted for PT education. Now I think they operate by the name Pro Talent. But I would suggest that don't go by the fact that someone has done it, so I will do it there. Please explore what you need to do. Explore the faculty quality, temperament, the cost, timings, everything. Everything would matter because you need to create a balance of your current education and future education. So this is a very critical phase. It's not as critical as doctor's education, but yes, aapke liye time bahut important rahega. You need to focus on your education, your co-curricular activities. Aapme se kuch log working bhi honge, shayad family business mein thoda time dedicate karenge, ya fir kuch job lenge, part-time, something would be there. So just go out with an open mind, explore ki who is providing you the best option. Most important thing would be faculty, temperament and quality. See, I would say the institute's head in each of the options would be good enough. But there is a team of faculty who will ultimately be taking up classes with you, grooming you for the CAT exams. And there is no defined formula ki CAT ka aapko ye ye score aa gaya to aap successful ho jaoge. It also depends on ki us saal kitna competitiveness tha and also pressure mein aap kitna acche se operate kar pa rahe ho. So again, everything comes back to you only. Aap ghar pe baith ke preparatory course leke bhi aap successful ho sakte ho CAT mein. So choose your best option based on your requirements.
I'm so happy to listen to the importance of language. Yes, it is to be the skill sharpened. The next question was of making choice for the specialization. How to go for that while doing BBA, I guess. That is a question from second year student.
So, I don't know, I would just, share if allowed, I'll just share about, how things happened for me. So, that is a question asked by Jimnasha. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So,
yes.
Nasha, this is a question, you know, that is really a very tough question. Frankly speaking, you know, when we all pass through this period of our life, trust me, we really don't know what is the right and what is the wrong, because for us, it would matter because we are not able to see the bigger picture. So my tip here would be that, you know, being able to see that whatever you enjoy doing, you know, I always telling this that, you know, you really need to be passionate about something to be able to take a decision about your life. So what happens sometimes is that, you know, there are students who want to whose focus is like, okay, which business or which career would, you know, give me more money. So because we do coach a lot of students, so there are a lot of questions that, you know, which career would really help us earn enough and get the right job. And so money is not really the decision making factor. The factor here would be that what you are really personally good at, which you enjoy doing, you know, right from your heart. So even if nobody is paying you anything and still you want to do that, giving your 100% self, then that is the kind of specialization you would want, should ideally take. And, you know, how do you find your passion? Like to tell you, frankly, like, you know, during my first year of college, I felt that, you know, HR is something that I want to go with. And then eventually I felt really marketing, because I love to talk, so marketing is good for me. When I appeared for an, when I knew that there was some internship happening, so I still remember that during the initial, when it was not the final year, so I think it was the second year. So there was NJ India Invest from where, you know, this today it's a big name now. So they had come up with this internship requirement. So I went there, appeared for the interview with like four of my friends, and we were all interviewed. So that time I felt like, you know, I'm good at finance also, let me try and explore that too. I actually got selected. And for me, this entire, you know, I really grilled myself, giving my 100%, creating those financial models. But trust me, although I still have fantastic rapport with those people, I eventually felt that, you know, this is not something that I would enjoy doing. And then I, you know, took up marketing. So what I mean here is that, you know, unless and until you do not experiment with things. So like when you get, you know, choices to explore to your project, try everything and just see what gives you the real happiness. And then you feel like something that I enjoy the most. So then can, you know, decide that, okay, this is the kind of stream I want to go in. So that's how I selected, and then, you know, took up more and more opportunities, more and more, you know, platforms. Like there are events and there are so many things, projects happening. So the more you get into it, you realize that, okay, you know, this is my passion and this is what I want to really do. So I think a specialization should be based on your passion and things that give you happiness, and that will definitely give you success in future. You don't want to depend upon your decision.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. Is there any other question to the speakers? Satya, what's the question? I hope the question is related to life and career. Satyam
is asking.
Did you guys give some tips?
Asking about extracurriculars to be pursued.
sir, I would like to answer that.
Yeah, yeah.
We're waiting.
So, Satyam, I would the best thing that I would recommend you is to pursue as many as extracurricular activities that has been given to you by the college. BSM provides a bouquet of opportunities, more that probably you could manage all of them. So when I was in your shoes, I did that. So I took almost, I think, all the opportunities that was provided to me by the college. And I did that, and that has helped me a lot. So I would recommend you to take all the opportunities provided by the college. That could be an internship. That could be a research project, that could be any other opportunity or any other competition that is provided there. So over and above the college, if you really want to do something in terms of extra curriculum, I would suggest do virtual internships at Internshala, where you have the options of a lot of MNC companies who are coming in and providing opportunities, and where you could learn a lot sitting just in Surat, and you can get global exposure. So these two things I would recommend.
There are two more questions. I think it is about civil services and aviation and MBA. GMAT, and how it has helped you to build MBA? Yeah. Yes, sir.
Well, friends, the experts which we have called are not from exact career planning and counseling business. They are from training and life-related things. So anything related to decision-making process or attitude-related aspects, they would be better off. We might call somebody who can answer this kind of questions. But where to do civil service related preparation or something, I don't think they would be comfortable with. But still, if some of you are okay with, Nisha can answer.
Right. So, what would you like me address? The question.
No. If you are aware of something, you can add. Otherwise, right. I understand.
Right. Here, I think of somebody who's specifically professional into this would be the right person. Although I can give an idea, but I think a perfect professional should be the right person to answer this question.
Yeah, they. I guess we are done with some purposeful questions. For the speakers. Am I right, Jay, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. I would now request Huma Madam to present the vote of thanks. Huma Madam, to you.
Divya, request FY students, admission aspirants to stay back after vote
yes,
of thanks.
After the vote of thanks, we'll have the second segment, that is for admission in BRCA, the question answer session. Huma Madam, to you for vote of thanks.
All right. Good morning, everyone. It is my absolute privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. And I, on behalf of BRCM College of Business Administration, want to extend a very hearty vote of thanks to all the persons without whose help and cooperation it would not have been possible to organize this program. At this point, I remember a statement by John F. Kennedy, who once said, as we express gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. And today my words are not enough to express the gratitude. I would like to thank our speakers for the day, Ms. Nisha Anand, Mr. Piyush Bhutoria, and Mr. Hardik Shah, who despite their busy schedules, have found time to grace this occasion. Thank you all for sharing your experiences with us. We are truly inspired by your great words. I also take this opportunity to express our thanks to Director in Charge, Dr. Jayesh Desai, a dynamic and flexible person in all academic matters, for all his support and motivation. I'm very happy to express vote of thanks to all our faculty members. I owe a special gratitude to our faculty, Dr. Mrinal Joshi and Dr. Ushma Desai, who have worked very hard for creating all the technical support and to ensure that this webinar becomes a memorable success. I would also like to thank the wonderful class of second year who has turned up in such great numbers. And most importantly, we want to thank all the aspiring students for attending this session. Finally, thank you to all the viewers out there who are watching us live on different social media platforms. Thank you very much.
Thank Thanks a lot, Nisha, Hardik, and Piyush, for sparing your valuable time today. It was really, as you people were talking about, even memory got fresh for all of us during your time with college and afterwards. So thank you very much for sparing your time.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. And I would prefer that our teachers don't thank us for anything. the same way we would not expect our parents.
So sweet of you.
We 100% agree with you on that.
Yes. Yeah, no doubt about that.
Look forward to this kind of opportunities to be able to give back. You know, it's a great opportunity to do so.
Yes, we'll have the separate sessions now of all three of you with the separate different topics. Piyush sir, Hardik sir, and Nisha ma'am, if you want, you can leave the meeting now. I think the second segment, would be for admission.
Fine. Thanks a lot, Team BRCM. Bye. And all the best, my fellow students and batchmates of the second year. Thanks.
Bye.
Thank you.
Good day.
Thank you, Jayesh sir, Divya ma'am, Huma ma'am, Neha ma'am, Munar sir, Ushma ma'am, and all of the faculty members. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity.
We will connect again.
Keep in touch. Yes.
Yeah.
Divya, okay. Over to you. For
now, we are focused towards the students who are interested into admission in BRCM. If you have any query regarding getting admission in BRCM, you can please unmute yourself and ask, or you can write in chat box. Jayesh sir or all of us are there to guide you. Is there any query to the admission aspirants? Jo log BRCM mein admission lena chahte hain, un students ki baat kar rahi hu. If you have any query regarding the admission, you can ask. Is there anyone? All is sorted.
There was somebody who was interested in asking question related admissions. Well, friends, purpose of this second segment is, since you filled up your form for BBA, a good time has elapsed due to this corona pandemic related problems. University is delaying admission, and many of you are becoming unknown for that reason. So the purpose of this second segment is to help you understand. By chance, if you have some query, we can answer. Essentially, the program was to motivate students to decide their life and career. But we thought, why not to include our students about what to do? Yes, as for students, there is no admission-related query for you. So if you wish, you can leave. It is for the second segment is for admission aspirants only, and particularly those who are confused about admission process or any other questions about selection of a college or a process of admission or anything else. Yeah.
Deepika Verma is asking, when will be the results of application form for admission be announced?
Well, Deepika, let me tell you, first of all, this is a completely Veer Narbat South Gujarat University driven process. You have filled your form to university. At present, we do not have any data about applicants. Most probably, after all extensions, university has decided that there may not be more extensions. Generally, university takes 10 days time after last date of filling of application. And then they provide, they prepare merit list. After preparing merit list, they would provide one day to you all. They would provide, they would send message and they would put it on their website that you are given one day to correct your choices or any information which you want to update. So there would be one day provided to you for updating
if there is any error in your application, or if you want to change or add or delete certain colleges from your choices. Once that gets done, within 3 to 4 days, admission process would start from our side, but still, communication would take place through VNSU. Through your login, you would come to know that X college or Y college is allotting admission to you, and confirm it. If you confirm that admission in a given time, probably one day, your admission would get confirmed in that college. Once you take admission in one college, it's not that you cannot shift to other college. If your higher merit college comes down and gives you admission, you can approach that college. By approaching that college, you can tell them that your admission is confirmed in X college, but you want to confirm that admission in your in that particular college. They would initiate process through your consent and OTP. Your admission in previous college would get cancelled, and in newer college, your admission might get confirmed. This may go on till last date for admission process declared by Veer Narbat South Gujarat University. That's how it would be functioning. I hope I have answered your question regarding admission thing.
Satya Mishra is asking that he has a drop off year after 12th. So would it create any problem in getting admitted in VP?
No, you are still qualified for taking admission in BBA, Satyam. Of course, if you are you have made a drop, probably there it might affect your merit a bit. Again, that is done by university. They adjust years, different years by their own calculation. But after that, once merit is finalized, according to that merit number, admission would happen. So you are qualified for admissions. Don't worry about it. Whatever adjustment happens, positive, negative, that depends upon university formula. But once your merit number is finalized, admission happens strictly according to that merit number.
What is the criteria or cutoff for entering in VRCM? She has 9. Okay.
Well, is that be eligible for you? Yes, Satyam, you are eligible. Regarding cutoff, my friends, it is very difficult to remember, but university has put up this last year's merit on its website. Well, we are providing admission into some, based on some 12 different categories. Broadly, these categories are Gujarat board and other boards. And in each board, again, there is a science, and within each stream, science or commerce or arts, and both the boards, again, there is a reservation criteria. So friends, it is very difficult to remember it. But as far as I remember, for last year, for Gujarat board commerce, it was around 80%. CBSE commerce, it was around 90%. Reservation numbers, I don't remember exactly. But if you want to consult, everything is mentioned on Veer Narbat South Gujarat University's website, where you can see last year's criteria of not just VRCM, almost all colleges. One more thing, apart from last year's cutoff, this year cutoffs may change substantially because a lot of people are facing a lot of problems due to this pandemic. So last year's criteria are not a very good sign. What I suggest is, wherever you have applied, not just VRCM, all colleges, if you are interested in one particular college, wait till
take admission wherever you get, but wait till last round, because by last round, some changes may happen in admission cutoffs, and they might surprisingly go up or drop down. Very difficult to predict this time. And last year's criteria may not prevail.
When will be the merit list of the university be? When will the merit list of the university be out? Somebody is asking.
That is completely on university. As my friends, I told you, generally once the last date of submission is, goes by, which was 6th August this time, generally they take 10 days time. But again, this time, it may be slightly more or less due to this pandemic, because not just BRCM College, even Veer Narbat South Gujarat University and their executives are working from home, and they are working on campus, etc., which is creating some delay. So standard time 10 days, but it may get delayed a bit this time. Again, as per flexibility and feasibility at university, that is done by university. Right?
Sir, an important question. Somebody is asking that BRCM is good for study, but practical enrollment is not up to the level. It is better to know the fact from you.
Practical enrollment, what do you mean by that, Deepika? Exactly what you want to ask on practical enrollment, because there can be multiple interpretations of it, if you can clarify. There are no events. I think, Deepika, information with you is slightly wrong. We had a student from 1st batch, 5th, 6th batch and 11th batch. I think they were referring to some events, etc. This time they only increase rather than decrease. Right. Of course, we do it in our own manner. This Zill Taylor is our second year student who is confirming that there are many events which are happening in our college. Just to tell you, we are more academic focused, and that's why marketing of our event in big scale by spending money doesn't take place. But in-house events, there are numerous. Rather, some of this college who are doing big events, some of them have come afterwards, and they've taken up some of these events from us. But of course, some of these events they have scaled up, and marketing part, they are doing it at a very high level. Otherwise, if you are within college, our second and third year student and all alumni of 21 batches, which are out by now, would vouch that the number of activities or events which happen are numerous within time schedule provided by semester system. So I don't think there are no events. Of course, they are not scaled up to city level in marketing things.
Okay. Is there any other question related to admission in BRCM? Anyone? I think we are almost done with this segment also.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Our students, just a second, sir. Are students provided with some kind of internships or anything else?
Vidhi, there are two projects in a curriculum of BBA program, which you can call it as an internship. One, there is a summer training, which takes place after fourth semester final exams, where for 8 weeks you have to take placement in some organization, and you would be doing internship based on broad guidelines provided by college. And then there is second project or internship, which takes place during your sixth and final semester of BBA program. There is a difference between these two projects. That is, in first project, summer training, it's a generic in nature, means marketing, finance, HR, and production or operations. You have to see all this department, and based on that, you have to prepare your project report. There is change in system of this summer training from RBH, which is in second year. Earlier, this was not given credit or marks by university, but now from second year batch, that would be first batch in this restructured program, and they would get marks. So would happen for your batch as well. And six semester project attracts two subject worth of marks. So both these are internships projects from learning angle. As such, a lot of our students do internship apart from curricular requirement, where you might work part-time for learning and some earning kind of thing. There is not much formal, frankly telling you, there is not much formal system in our college to place you for those kind of placements. But that doesn't mean we don't help at all. Looking at less number of students looking for, as I told you, we have not created a formal system, but lot of organizations do approach. Lot of our alumni also do approach for such placement. So those who are interested, we do support them informally, but there is no formal system for that.
Is there any other question related to admission?
Admission or processes of BRCM. You can ask question regarding that also.
Being in BRCM, if you still have any confusion, doubt. Okay, I guess we are done, sir.
Okay. Thank you, friends, for your interest in BRCM.
Just a second, sir. To the students, student who asked for activities in BRCM, see, students, BRCM students are our lifelines. They are what BRCM is all about. So they are looking forward to the enthusiastic lot from you. I guess to you, sir. Now.
Yeah. So it was just thanking all the students who just passed 12th or last year they cleared it, but they want to enter into admission process for 2021 batch. If you join BRCM, it would be great, and we welcome you all. But essentially, that would happen through admission process set up by Veer Narbat South Gujarat University. Thank you very much.
Thank you for being with us. See you soon. You can leave the meeting now.
Thanking all the students who just passed 12th or last year they cleared it, but they want to enter into admission process for 2021 batch. If you join BRCM, it would be great, and we welcome you all. But essentially, that would happen through admission process set up by Veer Narbat South Gujarat University. Thank you very much.
Thank you for being with us. See you soon. You can leave the meeting now.
Thanking all the students who just